And welcome back in my reading corner. Thank you so much for joining me again for another unboxing. If you're new to my channel, hi, my name is Cece. I do mostly bookish subscription box unboxings. Sometimes I do bookish stuff, sometimes I unbox other stuff, but today we are staying right where I'm at my best, the bookish subscription box unboxings. We're looking at the Totally Booked crate today. The Totally Booked crate ships from the USA, costs $29.99, and I have added on shipping to that and have transferred that into your currency, and you can see a select location currency thing on the screen right now. So you have a very good understanding of what this box will actually cost you. So the cool thing about the Totally Booked crate is that there's a ton of selection you can do. So there's either the My Guilty Pleasure with like three or four different genres, like historical fiction, new adult, just pure romance or whatever. And then the Totally Booked crate, which comes with a YA book, and you can pick either contemporary or fantasy, or you can pick that you're gonna be surprised by which one you get. I actually don't remember what I picked. But overall, this is probably one of the prettiest boxes I have ever seen. It's so weird. I am very, very drawn to these typical like chick lit romance designs. I hate reading romance. I hate reading this kind of stuff. But the design is always so beautiful. And what we can expect in this box is one highly anticipated new release book. I think it's also a hardcover book. Sometimes, if available, it comes with a signed book plate and a letter from the author, and then 3 to 5 bookish items. The last box, I really did like the items, like a lot. It was a really good selection and the quality was really nice. So I was really, really satisfied with the last one. So I have high hopes for this one. The interesting thing is I have reviewed the Sparecraft box just a while ago, and the Sparecraft box, I was really surprised and I was kind of ranting. Look at the June Sparecraft box video. I've been ranting about the customer service and how they're approaching, like how they're positioning themselves. What I have found out actually is very, very weird. The whole FAQ text from the Sparecraft box is almost the exact same wording than the Totally Booked crate, except for these things that really put me off, where it's like forced down your throat, that they're not responsible. These are missing. So the wall text is the same here, but it feels like a Sparecraft copied the whole FAQ and then added in just where they wanted to be very clear that they don't want to be annoyed by the customers, that they don't want to see any emails, and that they're not responsible for anything. It might sound like I'm exaggerating, but go look for yourself. Watch my video, look for yourself, like read through that FAQ and tell me how you feel. With this, even though it's the same wording for most of the areas, they have sentences in there like, We'll figure something out. We'll make it work somehow. They do say, well, all sales are final and this stuff, that's fine, but they don't write it in bold letters like 100 times on the page. And the big difference, for example, was, well, you can cancel or you can skip. And on Sparecraft box, they say, we can't do that for you. We're not going into your account and doing that for you. We're just going to cancel when you've skipped 3 times and we need your space. They say, well, this is how you cancel, and then they just stop and don't antagonize about like, we're not gonna do that for you. I'm going off topic. Let's look what's inside here. I'm quite excited. Why am I rambling about these FAQs when I wanna know what's in here? Let's see. Actually, you know what's really cool is the cover is actually clean. There's nothing. Where's the customs declaration? Did I already remove it? No, it's all here. That's cool. So I can replace it with a broken one. Yay! All right, so this is what it looks like. And, oh, there's a little note. Extra gift since we had a delay. Thanks for being patient. You're awesome. Love, Ginny. Honestly, I totally forgot that this came late, but they're right. It did come late. So this is nice. And that's a nice touch to have that on there. And that's handwritten. Oh my gosh. You must have like, okay. So the theme of the month is a whole new world. This is what the spoiler card looks like. And the spoiler card is done really, really well. On the very left, it says it lists the goodies, and then in the middle, it says the book of the month for the two different, like the contemporary and the fantasy. On the top, book and candle box, you get like you can also order just a book and candle box, and then on the right, it's a preview just of the September theme, which is Twisted Retellings. And I already know what book that's gonna be. Oh, let's do that on camera. Let's see, remove that paper, remove some air. Ah, that was too stupid to pop it. And oh my gosh, do you see that? Do you see that? Oh, oh, look at this, look at this, look at this. Oh my gosh, that is awesome. I mean, I'm not getting this in the Waldo Wizardry box, and I'm like yelling at them for like the longest time because they're not giving us things. Oh, now I remember they did ask what house I am. That is so awesome. I mean, it's just a tie, but it's, wow, this is nice quality. Oh, wow. I have no idea how to tie a tie. I have to figure out how to tie a tie now, I guess. I have no idea how to do it. So I'm just gonna wear it like this for now. But I wanna wear it like this, let's see. I'll have to figure out how to tie a tie now. This is awesome quality. I'm impressed. Damn, I'm impressed. This is really good quality. A Harry Potter house tie. Pack your trunks and get ready to head to Hogwarts. We'll take care of your uniform. Which house did you get sorted into?
I'm so excited.
Okay, what else do we have? Laszlo's dreams. So we scent is dreamy herbs, wood, and citrus. I was like, what's atrus? It's citrus. That's interesting. It does smell a little bit like an air freshener for your toilet. Oh yeah, it totally smells like toilet. It's probably because of the citrus. I don't know, but oh, that's not for me. It totally smells like toilet. I'm sorry, but it's a candle. I mean, there's nothing wrong with a candle. Totally Book Crate exclusive Laszlo's Dreams. Candle inspired by Strange the Dreamer. We hope it reminds you to dream up something wild and improbable. It was designed by the creative Jess from Flickering Fandoms. The next item, ooh, that's a wand pencil. That is cool. A pencil wand because we can't send you to Hogwarts unarmed. It was designed by the talented Amber from Curiously Creepy. This is really nice. I like this. I'm loving this box already. So this might become my new favorite box. What else do we have? Is this a bracelet? A crystal charm bracelet inspired by Aladdin. Let's open that up. Said it's silver, so I'm not wearing silver, but this is quite cute, and it's like you can, it says shining, shimmering, splendid, and it has like the little lamp and a little purple and a little blue, like a little stone. Let's see if it actually, I don't want to jinx it. I might not get it out, like my fetus arms, like my fighter's wrists aren't supposed. So this is cute. This is going into my giveaway. If you don't know that yet, I do monthly giveaways where I give away all the items that I'm not using that come in the subscription boxes. And this is one of them, simply because I have fighter's wrists and I only wear golden jewelry, and this is silver. It's cute though. And then we have a piece of paper. This is probably an art print. If you have watched a few of my unboxings lately, you probably know how I feel about art prints. I don't want any more art prints. We're getting too many art prints in these boxes, and usually they're too subjective. There's nothing I can do with it besides hang it on my walls, and I'm not hanging something on my walls that I don't seriously love. Oh, so this is a map of Caterdam. This is quite nice. I don't know who would like that and hang it on a wall, but this is really nice. A map of Caterdam inspired by Six of Crows. How could we not include a bookish map in a book box inspired by world building? It was created by the talented Erica from Nocturnal Fey Art. So this is quite cool. I don't have a use for it, so this is going in my giveaway. I believe this might be the extra item, because this is not on the spoiler card, and these are headphones. Like earplug headphone thingies. I know that these aren't expensive to create, and these usually come from China very cheap, and then you have your logo printed on top. It's not an expensive item, but it is a really cool item. And I can use these. Actually, well, my son can use these. He needs a new headset, so that's cool. This did talk about a bookmark inspired by the YA fantasy pick of the month, but I don't see the bookmark. Let's see if it's in here with the book. I did get the contemporary book. I didn't get the bookmark. I don't see it, so but that's not the end of the world. So the book that I got is The Girl You Thought I Was. So I'm getting the contemporary again. I'm guessing that I picked contemporary because I'm getting so many fantasy and I wanted to change. This says, our YA contemporary pick of the month is The Girl You Thought I Was. In this new YA mystery novel, appearances can be deceptive. On the outside, it looks like Morgan has everything put together. That is until she's caught shoplifting. But that is not her only secret that's about to be exposed. We hope you enjoy the story full of mistakes, romance, and forgiveness. Sounds interesting, it sounds different, and I'm here for it. I need some change. Oh, that's boring though. And what we did get with it is a signed booklet. It says, happy reading, Rebecca Phillips. And then a nice letter from the author, which is always really nice. It's totally fine to have it on a simple piece of paper. I don't mind that at all. And that is it. I mean, what am I saying? That is it. It's awesome. So we have the book, we have the tie, the map, the candle, the wand, the bracelet. I mean, I'm satisfied with the second book. I can't wait for the next boxes to see if they keep up this like quality of content. If they do, I'm really, really impressed, and I'm going to really, really recommend this because I can pick if I want contemporary or fantasy, which is a major downside to some of the other boxes. So let's get to the ratings. Beauty. There's no design inside the box. The main item is not wrapped. There's no other material. So 2 out of 5 points. Being special, there are letter from the author, etc. No ads or add-ons, no exclusive service, so 3 out of 5 points. Service gets 5 out of 5 points. Worth, let's calculate it up. As always, or as I'm saying in the last couple of videos, I'd be really interested to hear your assumption of the worth of the items. So again, we have wand, bracelet, candle, headphones, and this art thing, and then the book, which is $17.99. I get to a worth rating of 1.425, which it gives us 5 out of 5 points. So altogether we have 18 out of 25 points, which is a good 3.5-star rating. I really do like this box a lot. I do believe that it has, like, this has deserved more than a 3.5-star rating. This is a really, really good contender. I love the variety of products that are in here. It's different. I don't feel like it's been overdone, and I don't feel swamped with cheap items. So I am very happy. Very, very happy. So I can't wait for the next box to come. Until then, I have a contemporary to read that I'm probably not going to get to because I have too many books on my TBR. I still want more. All right, this is it for today. I hope you enjoyed what you saw. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button to show me some love and support me. And before you leave, do make sure that you check out my giveaway and enter my giveaway, because winning cool stuff. All right, see you then. Bye.